Welcome to Oracle Gold Ingot Tools demo session. If I come to my profile, so I have overall 10 years of real time experience as an Oracle DBA. When I come to my online training experience, 8 years I have been almost around 6 years, since 10 years I have been working as an online trainer on different technologies like Oracle RAG DBA, Golden Gate, Performance Tuning, DataGuard, Sales System, and Docker and Kubernetes. So this is about myself. Coming to the course curriculum, we can go through the different chapters in this course curriculum, so that we'll get understand what we are going to cover. So in the first chapter, we are going to discuss about the indexing about the Golden Gate. So how Golden Gate came into picture and different topologies that support different platforms, databases. So that we are going to cover in the first chapter. Then coming to the second chapter, so that is Golden Gate architecture. In case of Oracle Database architecture, here Golden Gate is also having its own architecture. So we should understand the architecture. So once you understand this architecture, then you can easily move further to perform the replication within the Golden Gate. So next chapter, installing Oracle Golden Gate. So it is very important to understand how to install the Oracle Golden Gate software, because as we are going to use the Golden Gate software for replication, so it is very important and mandatory thing to understand how to install the Oracle Golden Gate software. Next chapter is coming to preparing the environment and configuring integrated extract. So basically, here in this chapter, we are going to cover how we can perform or what we are going to do before we perform the replication. So basically, we cannot straight away perform schema replication or table replication straight away once we've done the installation. So it's not the case. So we should perform or we should prepare the environment. So that we are going to cover under preparing the environment in simple words. Then next chapter, configuring initial load. So here, coming to the configuring initial load, if you want to replicate data from one database to other database, the target database should have same structure and same data level. So to achieve that, so one of the best method in the Golden Gate is initial load. Using initial load, we can copy the data, or we can make sure the data is same level in the source and the target databases. So we will see, going forward, we'll see how to configure the initial load, how to use the initial load. So we'll discuss everything. So in this slide, still we have remaining chapter, configuring change delivery. Nothing but it in simple words, you can say it is a replicate process. It is all about replicate process. So here we are covering what is a replicate process, how we can configure, and what are the other things that require for the replicate to configure, like checkpoints, using checkpoints, adding checkpoints, collision, how we can work with collision in case of the replicate process, and viewing, and also we can view the report files and log files. If replicate process abandoned for some reason, so we should be able to go and see what is the reason for that. So for that, we have corresponding log files and report files, so we can go and see that. Next chapter, managing extract trials and files. So basically, trial files are used to store the data temporarily on the disk. So the basic motto behind using these trial files in the Oracle Golden Gate is you can overcome any data loss through the network when the replication is being in the flow from the source database to target database. So we can see how to configure trial files and what are the different trial files we have. Local trial file, remote trial file, and we can also see how to clean up the trial file, and we can also read the trial file as well. So basically, there is a utility called logdump. Using that, we can read the trial file as well. And so in few scenarios, we should require that utility, using logdump utility to read the trial file. So we'll see going forward when we can use the logdump, how we can read the trial file within the Golden Gate. Next chapter is Oracle Golden Gate parameters. So basically, the Golden Gate replication is purely depends on how we are using the parameters. Like in case of Oracle database, so we have parameters concept, right? In the SQL or key file, we are going to mention what are the parameters we need. Similar to that, here also we have Golden Gate parameters where we can use those parameters to fulfill our requirements. For example, I'll give you a simple example. Let's say, for example, I want to connect to the Oracle database from the Golden Gate. So for that, I need to use some parameters. So like that, we have plenty of parameters available. So based on the need, we can make use of the each and every parameter. The next chapter is data selection and filtering. This is very simple actually. So here, in case of Oracle database, if you want to filter out the data from a table, let's say the table is having 1 lakh records, and I want to display only the employee salary who are having greater than 5,000. Then I can use where clause, where salary greater than 5,000. In the similar way, how we are doing the filtering in the Oracle database, similar way we can also do the filtering in the Golden Gate. Okay, so that talks about data selection filtering. So we are going to talk about different areas like data selection and where condition, filtering, mapping, exclusion. So these we are going to cover in this chapter. And coming to the last chapter, bidirectional replication. In the bidirectional replication, we are going to see what is as a tutorial view and different configurations, data looping, resolving complex and effects of Oracle sequences. So this is very interesting part. The working mechanism of bidirectional replication in the GoLangit is very interesting because we are going to perform the replication in 2 ways, source to target as well as target to source. So when we do this kind of setup, so what are the consequences we can face and how we can overcome those consequences? So even that we can discuss in this chapter. So that is all about the course curriculum. So coming to today's agenda, why do we need GoLangit? Why GoLangit required for us to implement replication? Yes, definitely you should understand the answer to this question. Because every software, not only GoLangit software, any software that you want to learn, first you should understand why you are going to use that software. Anyhow, we will going forward, we will discuss how we can use that software by configuration, by doing some configuration and all. Okay, so that is secondary part. So first thing, why you should understand why you are going to use. So to understand that, let me give you some introduction about the GoLangit. So basically, GoLangit is a separate organization 2 years back, and Oracle Corporation has acquired GoLangit Corporation, and Oracle has started using GoLangit as a replication software. So here replication means in case of GoLangit, so we are able to do the replication table level and the schema level. So here I can also compare the GoLangit with the data guard. In the Oracle data guard, we have data guard concept, because in data guard also we have similar kind of replication configuration available, but there are few differences. I can say there are few or couple of disadvantages that we can see in case of data guard. So what are those disadvantages, or what are those negatives we can see with in case of Oracle data guard? First let me tell you about those disadvantages, then we'll move to the GoLangit advantages also. Okay, so here in the Oracle data guard, let's say there is a primary as configured in the US and the secondary database is configured, or physical database or data guard configured in India. Now we know that all the data will be replicated from primary database to secondary database, but here in what format the change will be applied from primary database to standard database? So it will be applied in the form of archive log file. So that means here we don't have choice to choose whether you want to go for the replication at a table level or whether you want to go for the replication at schema level. Okay, here you don't have that option in case of Oracle data guard. So these are the couple of disadvantages you can understand in case of Oracle data guard. So and when you come to the Oracle GoLangit, you can overcome those disadvantages. How we can overcome? Because in the Oracle GoLangit, you can perform replication at table level, we can perform replication at schema level. And not only performing table level and schema level, it has lot of other advantages. We will see one by one. Okay, going forward in the next upcoming slide, we will discuss few other advantages as well. And moreover, Oracle GoLangit supports a different topology. So let's discuss that. So here I can discuss those points under by covering GoLangit in depth. Basically, GoLangit is a software or replication tool using which we can perform the copy of data from one database to other database sitting in a same server or in different server. So here, as I told you, GoLangit have lot of advantages. So with the help of a GoLangit, we can provide the high availability solution, we can provide the near zero downtime migration in case of Oracle databases and real-time data integration. So like that, we have a lot of advantages are available with the help of a GoLangit. So majorly, a GoLangit is very useful. So when you want to go for zero downtime migration or for high availability solutions, so these are the two major areas where we can use the GoLangit. But apart from that, we know that using GoLangit, you can also copy or replicate data from one database to other database. So why we need GoLangit? Already we covered a couple of points about the GoLangit, right? Why we need GoLangit, right? Still there are few other points we need to discuss. So the first thing is GoLangit is heterogeneous environment. Here heterogeneous environment nothing but, let's say I have a very big data center and I'm maintaining my customers or clients data which belongs to different applications and which belongs to different business. Let's say some applications are running in SQL Server database and some applications running in Oracle databases, and some applications are using MySQL and some applications are using some other database. Now let's say I got a requirement to copy data from MySQL Server database to Oracle database. That is my requirement. I got that requirement from one of the customers. Then how can we fulfill this requirement? Yes, there is a way to fulfill this requirement in the GoLangit. So that is with the help of heterogeneous option, or the GoLangit support heterogeneous platform. Heterogeneous platform nothing but you can perform the replication. So one database to other database. So the source database may be anything and the target database may be anything. And apart from that, GoldenGate also supports Oracle to Oracle. So that is by default anyhow. And apart from that, it also supports heterogeneous platforms, such as MySQL to Oracle, Oracle to NoSQL Server, like this. Oracle GoldenGate also supports the DDL replication, because most of the time we also come across executing DDL commands. What is the DDL commands you execute in the source database? So that has to be created in the target, because if you want to insert some data, you have to create one table. Instead of creating the table, we can't insert the data. So that is the reason to apart from the DDL operations as well, whenever we require. So that is the reason the DDL also can be supported by the GoldenGate. But the DDL or the DDL replication by default cannot be supported by the Oracle GoldenGate. For that, we need to have separate configuration. Okay, so going forward, once we start the session, so I'll cover how to configure the DDL replication in the GoldenGate. Apart from these different advantages and different heterogeneous platform support, the GoldenGate also having or GoldenGate also supports different topologies. Different topologies nothing but, let's say for example, you have one source database and you have one target database. So now just setting up the application from source database to target database. So here, let's say my source database name is A and my target database name is B. So now you started replication from A to B. That's it. So now your all data is copying or replicating from A to B. So that is called unidirectional replication. And similarly, I got another requirement. Or let's say I want to consolidate all my data at the end of the centralized server. Let's say I have a couple of servers, or I have few of servers in different countries, and my centralized server is there in India. Okay, let's say Singapore, Malaysia, and Bangkok. So in these three different countries, I have three different servers. My centralized server is there in the India. Okay, at the end of the day, I want to consolidate all this information to my centralized server. So this is called consolidation of the data or consolidation. So here, you are just pulling all the information to the centralized server, and then you can use that information for any recording purpose. So here the concept is, you can also set up the replication like in this way also. Okay, like you in the source side, you'll be having multiple databases, but in the target side, you have only one database. This is called consolidation. So similarly, we have a data at the source side, we have only one database. At the target side, we have multiple databases. So this is called broadcast. Of broadcasting is similar. And let's say at source side, you have a database called A, and target side, you have three databases, B, C, D. Now, all the data from A is being replicated to B, and it is being replicated to C, and it is being replicated to C. See, this means you are just broadcasting your data to different databases using the GoldenGate configuration, okay, or using the GoldenGate software. And similar way, we have a couple of other different way of different ways of replication available. So, like for example, there are four databases A, B, C, D, and these are all residing in different locations. So now I want to perform replication from A to B, then B to C, then C to D. So this is called cascading. So here, why we are calling this cascading? Because you are copying data from A to B, then immediately you are copying whatever the data that B is having. So you are copying to the C, then from C to you are copying B. Here the data is moving from sequentially from A to D. So that's why we can say it is cascading replication method. So and the last one is bidirectional replication. So this is also one of the replication methods. So here bidirectional replication method nothing but, so let's say you have database A and you have database C. So here first you configure A to B. So that means all data will be copied from A to B. Then again, let's say you want to copy data from B to U. Yes, you can configure that way also. This is called your bidirectional replication. So making all the configurations from A to B, then B to U. Okay, this is called bidirectional replication. Okay, together, whatever the different methods, replication methods we have discussed, like unidirectional, consolidating, broadcasting, cascading, bidirectional. So all together we can say topology. So these are called different topologies that can be supported by the Oracle GoldenGate. You should understand what is a topology, the terminology topology, before you go for the further session. So that's why I just covered the terminology called topology, and also you should understand the terminology called heterogeneous. Just try to understand these technical terms within the GoldenGate, because when you try to use these technical terms, so that is good whenever you talk about GoldenGate. Now we are going to have some overview on extract as well. Here, before we talk about extract, so I'll tell you what is extract in the GoldenGate. So basically, extract is one of the capturing process. Then what will capture? So it will capture all the changes that are being made to the data. So all the changes it will capture that are being made to the database. So from where it will capture, either it will read the changes from the ready log file, or it will read the changes from the RC log file. Because here, why do we have two sources to capture the changes? Because whenever ready log files are overwritten and the data is available in the RC log file, the GoldenGate will go and read the data from the RC log. So that is the reason So the first priority will be given to the redeveloper. Then if the redevelopers are not available or if the data is not available within the redevelopers, Golden Gate Extract process will go and look into the RC logger. So then we can configure extract in the different ways. Using initial load and using change synchronization. So let me tell you what is the initial load or what is the change synchronization. Here, initial load is one of the capturing mechanisms. So that directly reads all the data. So whatever the table data that you want to load and that you want to import into the target database. Here, I'm using a term called import. So this import is not equal to Oracle database import. So here, I would like to tell you, using initial load, you can initially make data at the same level in both source and target databases. So let's say, for example, in the source database, assume you have one table that is having 1 lakh records. Okay, but in the target, the table is not there. Then just go and load, create the table and load the data. You have to do this, so you can go with initial load. So initial load is a mechanism that belongs to Oracle Golden Gate. Okay, but basically to load the data initially from source to target database, you can also depend on Oracle database export and import utility. Or you can say simply EHDDB and IMDB. Okay, because if you have your source database having huge data, so either you can go with the HTTP, INTTP, or either you can go with the Armin backup, okay? Armin cloning or Armin restoration. In case of huge data, initial load may not give you the proper result, or it may not be useful in case of huge data. So, in case of huge data, either we can use HTTP, INTTP, or we can use Armin cloning or Armin restoration. So, and moreover, initial load is a one-time process, because if you want to perform the replication continuously, as I told you, both source and target will be at same data level. So as I told you, in the source you have the table that is having 1 lakh records. So you should also have same number of records in target. Now the data is at same level in source and target. Now let's say you started your business. Now connections are written to the source database. So what are the changes that are being generated in the source, that should be captured and that should be replicated to the target database. So that is your continuous replication, or you can say change synchronization is a continuous process or continuous replication. In the change synchronization, we can able to perform DML replication, and also we can able to perform DDL replication. So as I already told you in earlier slide, so to perform DDL replication, so we need to have additional configuration. So by default, Golden Gate may not support DDL configuration. We have to perform some additional configuration to achieve or to replicate DDL operation within the Golden Gate. Now we will talk about data pump. The data pump that we are able to see is not equal to the data pump we will be having the Oracle database. This data pump is different. So let me tell you what is a data pump first. With respect to Oracle Golden Gate, a data pump is one of the extract process. You can say one of the secondary extract process or extract group. So that can be used to read the all modified data from the file set. But data pump process doesn't capture the data actually. Okay, it doesn't capture the data actually from the source database. Just it reads all the changes that are kept in the trial file. That's it. In the interview, let's say if anyone asks you what is the data pump, you can say it is one of the extract process where it can read data from the trial file, but it cannot read the changes from the redo log file or from the RG log file. Then what is the purpose of having data pump in the Oracle Golden Gate? Yes, I'll tell you. Definitely you should understand. So here, without data pump, when you configure replication, so you are going to use extract process in the source and the replicate process in the target. I'll tell you about replicate later after this slide. But here I would like to tell you about the reason behind using the data pump. Now come back to let's say extract process is available in source and then replicate process is available in target. So now you configured extract, you configured replication. Okay, now the replication started, data is going to the network. Anyhow, we know that, so these two servers should be communicated to the network and all the data be communicated or should be moved to the network. Suppose, let's say for example, if the network is damaged or the data packets in the network, if the data packets are damaged, then how can you make sure, so you are replicating all the changes from source to target, so you cannot make sure that means to overcome any data loss, so we can depend on the data pump in the Oracle Golden Gate. In this diagram, so we can understand the overall picture of Golden Gate architecture. So let me tell you about what are the terminologies or what are the terms you are seeing in this diagram one by one. Here we are able to see extract, manager, collector, data pump, trial, replicate, initial load, change synchronization. We already covered initial load and change synchronization. Okay, we should also cover once again. Don't worry about that. Okay, but let's talk about extract. But before that, you should understand there is one of the major process called manager process. So here, manager process is one of the main process. Simple words, in layman words, I can say CDJ boss or all other processes in the Golden Gate. That means it has some control over the other processes in the Golden Gate. Like it can stop or start the other process like extract, pump and replicate like this. So major process is a main process that that can control all of the process. It will monitor all of the process. And the manager process by default will be running on the default port number. Like in case of Oracle database, so listener will be running on the default port number on 1.21. Right? Here also in GoldenGate we have default port number. So by default the manager process will be running on that port number. That port will be enabled by the network team before we start the replication. So then coming to the extract process. Extract process as per the diagram. So these are your read log files. So these are your read log files. So here all the changes are being captured by the extract, and here and these changes are being transferred to the network to the target data. Here in this same diagram we have two configurations if you observe properly. So this bottom diagram let you know the usage of data pump passes, but in the top diagram, so it will show you the replication without data pump. So first of all let me tell you without data pump, then we will discuss with data pump. So just now we have discussed what is the advantage of data pump using in the GoldenGate. So here this configuration is without a data pump. Here extract was reading data and it is coming to the network. To the network, all the data is coming here to the target. So now, for example, let's say your network is damaged or your network is down. Then how can you make sure your data is not lost, or how can you make sure your data is, you are not losing your data? So that you can overcome with the help of data pump. And here in this case, they are using initial load. So initial load also we have discussed in the earlier slides. Right? So using initial load, you can make data at the same level in both source and target. So coming to the data pump. Data pump is, we know that data pump is one of the secondary sources. Extract process where it cannot actually perform the data extraction. Instead, it will perform the reading the data from the trial file. See here, if you see the all these arrow directions, you understand the replication flow. So first of all, the extract process reading the data from here, focus on the source data set, and it is writing all data to trial file. Then it is writing, then data from the reading data from the trial file. Data to the target to the network. So here at target side, there is one of the background process called collector. So this collector process is one of the background process. So like in case of extract, manager, replicate and the data pump, so these are all foreground processes. You can see all these processes, or you can monitor all these processes from the Oracle GoldenGate instance, but you can't see collector process straight away because it is one of the background process. Okay, then what is the functionality of this collector process? It will collect all the data which is being received from the network, from the source database. Okay, then it will place all this data into the trial file. So we'll also talk about trial file. Okay, first of all, let me complete about the collector and replicate. So collector receives data from the source and it will write data to the trial file. Then replicate process is a process that will be running in the target. It will read all the data from the trial file. Then it will construct some SQL and it will apply the data to the target data. So that is your replicate process. See, here in yellow color there are some boxes and here in red color some there are boxes. Right? So these are called trial files. So what is the use of trial file? If you want to avoid data loss when the data is moving to the network, you can avoid that with the help of trial files. You can store all the changes which are being read from the database. You can place them into trial file. So even though you lost the network, still your data is there available in the trial file. So that is the way you can save your all the changes, or you can just protect your all the changes in terms of trial file. So here the trial files that are available at the source side is called local trial file, and the trial files which are available at the target side is called remote trial file. So why do we need two files, remote trial files? Because in the source side extract will feed the data, so in the source side data pump will read and will send to the target. So all the data will be again placed in the remote trial file. So from the remote trial file, the trial file will take the data and it will write data to the target database. So change generation we have discussed here in the previous session, or in the previous slide. And also we have discussed the initial load as well. So this is all about how we can understand the replication flow and what is the initial load, what is the change generation, what is the extract process, what is the manager process, what is the trial file, what is the pump process. Now coming to certification. So it is very important to understand about the certification in case of GoldenGate. I'll tell you the need of certification and the importance of certification. So first thing, when you come to the need, if you write the certification, you'll get a lot of technical skills because you will prepare yourself all the subjects thoroughly and you'll appear for the exam. That is the first major point. Second point, the purpose is, so when you have certification, you'll be getting more priority when compared with the other colleagues or other teammates, or when you go for the interview, you'll get the more priority. So that is the one thing. And how you can and what is the certification name? So the certification name is Oracle GoldenGate 2HC Certified Engineering Certificate. So this is the certification name. You can go and register in the Oracle site, and you can choose one of the available date and you can write the exam. So that is all about the certificate available in case of cold exit. So what we are going to see demonstrate. So apart from few other demonstrations, we are also covering the unidirectional replication as well as bidirectional replication. So in case of unidirectional replication, we are going to take a source database, cache database, and we are installing Linux operating system, and we are taking reference environment, and we are setting up the replication. So we are going to see both schema replication as well as table replication in case of unidirectional. So in the similar way, in case of bidirectional replication, so we are going to have two systems or two databases where we are going to have Linux platform. On top of it, we are going to have RESTful database environment. Okay, here also we are going to see table replication as well as schema replication. That's what we are going to cover in the demo. To perform the lab, you should have your laptop with the following configuration. Like it is have 8 GB of RAM, and as we are going to most of the time, majority of the time, so we are in the real time as well. In the real time, so most of the time the customers are using Linux platform. So that's why we should be focusing on Linux environment. Okay, anyhow, if you have any doubt on the Windows side, I can clear the doubt as well. Then coming to the hard disk, minimum should have 50 GB of hard disk. So you can consider these as a prerequisite to set up your lab. You have some additional course resources. Here you can have some session, all the session videos, documentation, useful references, samples, resume as well, and some resume preparation and guidance as well. So I mean to say, you'll be getting the video session that we are going to have with hands-on documentation as well. Then some useful blogs or articles, some YouTube videos, okay, some sample resumes, then some preparation, resume guidance as well. If you have doubts, we can discuss here. Okay, the doubts you can ask me regarding the course curriculum and the timing and the lab setup, everything you can ask. The remaining questions you can the course timing, resource allocation can be discussed with the Mindnight people or the team. So that is all about for today's demonstration. So thanks for joining.